Somebody at the back.
Ian.
The Westminster Park has been very much more shape of what fellows do plan to go. There was a talk at the Bible University the other week that was made that it would be so complex to get support in 7 years, such as bad things that were tied in the Act of the Union in 1707. What powers will you be pushing for specifically? Until we get independence, obviously, but more than what powers will you be pushing for from Westminster?
We're pretty much pushing for all of them. I mean, to be serious, though, we've made a submission to the Smith Commission, which makes the case for devo max. Now, the definition of devo max is pretty much everything except foreign affairs, defence, intelligence services, you know, probably large parts of immigration, the sort of things that, if you're not independent, you couldn't really control within a devolved context. So that's what we'd argued for. Substantial powers over tax, substantial powers over welfare, regulatory powers, power over energy, all of the things that we really need, you know, so powers over employment policy, over the minimum wage. These are the things that you really need to do what I've been talking about, grow your economy and tackle inequality. So that's what we are arguing for. I mean, we were pretty upfront at the start of the whole Smith Commission process. I know it's not going to deliver independence. You know, we can only do that through a referendum, and it won't deliver everything we're asking for short of independence, but it's got to get pretty close to that if it's going to meet the expectations that were set in the referendum by the party leaders that came up one day for a day trip and made that big grand promise on the front page of the Daily Record. So we'll see where that process goes. You should kind of understand this. The Smith Commission will report next week, the end of next week, so it will, by the end of next week, set out what powers it thinks should be devolved to the Scottish Parliament. Now, who knows whether that will add up to much. I hope it does. I've got a lot of optimism for that process, but whatever it recommends, it's still the Westminster parties that have to deliver it. I don't know if you remember the Calman Commission a few years ago. It recommended a whole long list of powers that were never ever delivered. So we've, no matter what the Smith Commission recommends or doesn't recommend, we've got to keep the pressure on in the Westminster election, otherwise none of it will be delivered. So in short, we'll argue for as much as possible, and we'll let people judge what comes forward, and we'll see what it adds up to.